Yes, hi, I'm Novelist. It was Gatehouse, isn't it? Hi, I'm Novelist, and I'm at the Gatehouse at Abbey Road. Really enjoying myself right about now. You know what time it is. It's the N-O. Peace. When I was first aware of Abbey Road, Abbey Road is a household name. So I couldn't say the first time I heard of Abbey Road, because you always hear Abbey Road, the Beatles and the other guys. But I remember the first time I was actually educated on it was when I was doing a music course in college, and I had a teacher. He was just fascinated with the place. Like, I don't know if he ever stepped foot inside of Abbey Road, but he was fascinated. He was always talking about Abbey Road. And I said to myself, oh, I'm going to go there one day. Not to prove a point, but just like, if it's really what everyone says it is, I'm going to be there. And look, you know what I mean? I'm in here. You can see the backdrop, you know what I'm saying? You can see the hardware, so I'm here and I'm glad that I can be here. Well, my boy JD Reid, he hit me up. He's like, yeah, Nov, I've got a day in Abbey Road. So I was like, cool, man. Because we was working on a tune called Ready from beforehand. And the song's basically about just being active, being prepared for whatever comes next. So that's kind of what we've advanced on doing today. Yeah, well, I really enjoyed the environment because it was just like a secluded area, you know. People have to actually use a door key to get in. So I know that I'm not going to be getting disturbed by anyone or anything. It was a good vibe. And also, whatever mic is in the booth that I was using was a special mic, you know what I'm saying? So I really enjoyed, it's going to sound so arrogant, but I enjoyed the sound of my voice on that mic, you know what I mean? I can feel the vibe, you know what I'm saying? It feels legendary just being here, you know what I mean? Even though this is a new build, it's still the same energy, you know what I mean? Old school mics, you know what I mean? Yeah. We got old guy who fixes them, so you know what I mean? I feel just as legendary as the legends. Yeah. You know what I mean? Because I'm getting the same sound quality, the same kind of energy towards my music, same like freedom and openness. I can just walk around, start playing drums and doing whatever, you know what I mean? There's no like, you know, some studios are really like square, and I feel like music's art. You can't be square with art. There's no way of doing it, you get me? You know what I mean? And this place be a part of my legacy, because even just being here the one time is like, I can actually say, yeah, I've done a song at Abbey Road Studios. You know, hopefully my name goes down on the list of legends that have done things here, you know what I mean? So that's kind of, it's a blessing to be able to even be a part of that, you know what I mean? Feels cool, man, because my intention was to just to show people what actual grime music sounds like more than anything. I mean, anything else other than the sound is additional, because the first time I wrote a lyric, I wasn't thinking about anything other than the sound. So I feel like now people are acknowledging me as one of the people who actually pushed that, like the original sound. That's I appreciate it, because it gives me a sense of fulfillment, and I understand that whenever I make songs, people are going to receive it in a certain way, more so than this is just another guy who's doing the music. You know what I mean? Because you have a lot of musicians that come and go, but I never intended from the start, I never intended on being a person who floated. I always wanted to make my stamp. So I feel like even Logan Sama saying that and various other people saying things like that, just it's confirmation of what I always wanted for myself. All right, I'll tell you the truth, yeah? What I've been doing over the last couple years is just working on loads of music. So I haven't been putting things to projects. There's some things that I have for specific projects, like, I'm not going to say what, have songs designated for certain purposes. But I believe that you can't plan a vibe. So you have to literally catch a vibe, and then when it's time to put similar vibes together, then you put that out as a project. Okay, so this is what I was feeling at this moment in time. This is for this, oh, that's album music, or this is etc. So that's what I've been doing. I've just been working. And obviously I produce as well. I say obviously, it's not obvious, because if you don't know, you don't know. But I produced since I was about 6 years old, because my uncle, he introduced me into music. He had all the softwares and all of those things when I was younger. So I've just been producing a lot. And there's songs that I produced when I was probably about 14, 15 that I'm still due to vocal. You know what I mean? But I feel like everything's with good timing and you can't rush great music. And I don't really feel the pressure, because when you drop a song that's amazing, it's like, it's almost like you've time traveled, because people forget the wait that they've had to wait for. They feel satisfied. So I'm more concerned with people's satisfaction of the music and the vibe and the energy that the music will give than how long it takes. So that's just what I've been up to, man.